In this part, we will demonstrate how you will perform the analysis using online statistical analysis tool. So this tool is developed by me and it is freely available on our website. And the URL of the website is hu.ac.in, and under quick links, this is available in a tab labeled as online statistical analysis. And when you click on it, there are two options: OPSTAT for on-campus user and off-campus user. So you have to click on OPSTAT for off-campus user. Here you will see a list of techniques which can be a list of technique is there which are used for analysis, in which generating frequency, gross tabulation, comparing mean correlation analysis, and so on and so forth. Since we are confined only with the experimental design, so first I will demonstrate how to analyze your completely randomized design with unequal number of replication. So for that, I needed the data, and this data I have already copied from a book, Gupta et al., page number 25. And in this experiment, there are five treatments, and these treatments are the combination of various farmer practices, and then various fertilizers, and so on and so forth. And objective is to of this experiment was to find out the most appropriate integrated nutrient management. And this is the data, actual data. Once these treatments are applied to the plot, and they record the observation on dry matter accumulation. The first treatment is replicated 5 times, second, third, and fourth replicated 6 times, and fifth treatment is replicated 8 times. So in total, 31 experimental units are there. So these treatments are first arranged according to the treatment number. In first column, the treatment number 1 and the observation. Then treatment 2 replicated 6 times, so 2 is repeated 6 times, and in front of these 2, the observation you got from the measurement. Then third treatment, it is again repeated six times, and in next column you will fill the observations obtained from the experiment. And in this way, you can fill all the observation of 5 treatments in 2 columns, and then copy these 2 columns, only the data part. If you copy the data part only up to 5 treatments and copy it, now come to the OPSTAT page. Now from this page, click on the button compare means and paste your data in the place provided for it. Then enter the name of the character, it is DM, dry matter. Press enter, then submit. On submission, it will ask the number of parameters to be supplied. Since we have only two variable in the data file, so I type 2 here. Observation per variable, since 31 experimental unit are there, for variable number 1, which is treatment, and variable number 2, the diameter. Then we want to analyze dependent variable number. Since my second variable number is the actual observation for dry matter, so I put 2. And grouping variable is my first, in which I explain the treatment codes. So first is my treatment variable, and second is my actual variable, dependent variables. Then you opt for one-way ANOVA and press analyze. So your analysis is performed using this, in which you will get the descriptive statistics, group since five treatments are there, so five groups are there. The number of application 5, 6, 6, 6 and 8. Then these are the means. Now my objective is to find out which means differ significantly from which means. Whether 1 and 2 are different or same, 1 and 3 are different. Mean all possible comparison I want to make. So analysis of variance table can be created with the two sources of variation between groups and within groups, and F calculated is found to be significant. So we compare various groups, means using multiple comparisons. So one is compared with 2, one is compared with 3, one is compared with 4, one is compared with 5. So any difference with the star indicates that these two group means differ significantly. If you not find any star, it means that group behaves alike. For example, 2 and 3, no star is there. 2 and 4, no star is there. 2 and 5, no star is there. It means group means of group 1 and 2 differ significantly, and 2 and rest of the group 3, 4 and 5 with 2, they are at par. So in this way you can compare the group means with other group means. So by using this tool you can analyze your data in completely randomized design with unequal number of replications. Then second part, when you have equal number of replications, so I have another experiment. The data which I have collected from the Gomes and Gomes book, a very popular book on design of experiment, is there, in which these seven treatments are given to an experiment and there are four replications of each treatment, and the observation recorded on grain yield is listed here. So I just copy this only the observation part. Copy it, again go to the OpiStat homepage and click on one factor analysis. Then here you paste the data which you have copied. So only data part, no replication, no treatment, nothing else. In this case, the treatments are labeled as T1, T2, T3, T4, T5 and T6, 7. R1, R2 is the replication. You submit it for analysis and supply few parameters. The number of treatment we have 7, number of replication we have 4, and since we have only grain yield data, the number of corrector is 1. And then select design, either you can select RBD or CRD. Since our design is CRD, so I select it CRD and analyze it. So you will get the analysis of variance table, and in analysis of variance table we found that the treatment and the F calculated is significant. So we have to compute the CD. CD is automatically computed here, and with the help of this CD you can compare the any two means. For example, if 1 and 2 are compared, then what I do is I just take the difference of these two, and if this difference is more than CD, then we can declare that treatment 1 mean, treatment 1 and 2, they differ significantly. So analysis is very simple using this tool. Of course you can select the RBD also. Just by clicking on RBD, the same layout is there, same type of treatment is there, and analyze it. So you will get the analysis with one more source of variation, that is replication, and rest of the procedure is same. So it is a very simple tool. You can use it and analyze your data. Then second thing which I want to discuss here is two factor experiment. In two factor and three factor experiment, as I have mentioned in my theory part, that there are levels of two factor and in two factor experiment we have two factor each at certain levels. For example, if I take the data of two factor experiment, which is I think not, yes, This is a two-factor experiment in which I have three nitrogen levels, and these nitrogen levels are applied to six varieties. V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6 varieties are there. We have the nitrogen level N1, N2, N3. Asymmetrical factorial experiment is there. So in first column, I should the first column is representing your, you can say, first column will represent first column is representing your variety, second column is representing your nitrogen, and third column is representing your replication, fourth column is representing the observation you can have. So in this case, since we have five varieties, so and each variety is replicated in say three times, and three levels of nitrogen is also there. So in total, the variety 1 is repeated 9 times, 3 for nitrogen level and each 3 for replication. So one variety, first level of nitrogen, first replication. First level of variety, first level of nitrogen, second replication. First level of variety, first level of nitrogen, third level, third replication. In this way, arrange your data and copy this data for your analysis. So you can copy this data. So in total, you have 6 into 3 into 3. So 54 observations are there. So after copying the data, again, go to the main page and select two-factor analysis and paste your data here. After pasting the data, you submit for analysis. It will ask the levels for factor 1. First factor is my variety, so I have 6 levels. Second factor, I have 3 levels. There are 3 replications and only one corrector is there. Of course, you can select a 2-factor CRD, 2-factor RBD or split plot also, which is not discussed in our theory part. So you can select any one of these design. For example, if you go for CRD, select it and analyze it. So analysis is there. Here analysis of variance table contains factor ASS, factor B, interaction and error, and F calculated is not significant. In this case, we can say that none of the factor A, B and their interaction found to be significant. This is two-way mean table, and in CD part, not applicable means your F is not significant. That's why CD is not calculated. It is very simple tool. Everybody can use it. For RBD, you just select RBD. Rest of the things is same. Analyze it. And here you will see again, F calculated are non-significant. That's why CD is not computed. If we move for three factors, then again, go to the data file and find any of the, say, this is the data for three factor asymmetrical factorial RBD, in which we have S has two levels. It is given a field experiment with three varieties of potato and four levels of potassium on potato was tested in two spacing. There are two spacing, four variety, four levels of potassium. So there are four variety, V1, V2, V3, V4, two spacing S1 and S2 and four levels of potassium. So this is the data arrangement, and you arrange your data S1, V1, K0, S1, V1, K1 means keep the levels of S1 and V1 constant and vary the levels of potassium. And in this direction, you put your replication. First, you arrange your data, then second level of variety and vary this data. So these are the your treatment combination. You just copy this data. So we have two spacing, three variety, 2 into 3, 6, and four potassium level. 24 observations are there and 3 replications. So 72 observations are there. So after copying this data, what we do is we again go to the main home page, and select 3 factor experiments and place your data here. Submit, supply few information, level for factor 1, 2, because 2 spacing is there, and 3 varieties are there, and then 4 is the level of potassium, number of replication is 3, and we have only one character, one set which we want to analyze. So we can use CRD, RBD or split plot . These are the available design in 3 factors. So we are using CRD. Select CRD and press analyze button. So analysis is present in a separate web page. This can be copied or this can be printed also. And this is the analysis of variance table in which factor A, B, their interaction C, AC, BC and ABC. And their F value is calculated. Factor A is significant. By the significance p value, you can test whether it is significant or not. This b is not significant, interaction is not significant, c is significant. Then at certain level of significance, so you can find the values of cd only for those factors which are significant in ANOVA. So you can compare any mean. For example, if you want to compare the levels of A, means spacing 1 with spacing 2. So find your A into B table. These are the mean of 2 spacing. You just take their difference. If that difference is greater than this value, then we declare that these 2 levels differ significantly. Similarly, Factor C has 4 levels, C1, C2, C3, C4. And if you want to compare the difference of C1 with C2, so you take the difference. If absolute difference of these 2 levels is greater than this CD value, we can declare that these 2 levels differ significantly. So you can use RBD also. Just select your RBD part, analyze it, and analysis is available in the form of RBD also. You can use Leighton square design for one factor also, in which I want to demonstrate how will you present your data. Let me check if yes, this is the Leighton square. This is the Leighton square design. Actually, I have 6 treatment, and these are laid out in a Leighton square layout, and in which you have to arrange your data like this. In first column, the row, first row, first column, and which treatment the first row and first column will occupy. It is second treatment. This is first row, second column. First treatment is occupied, and this is the actual value of the observation you note. So after arranging the data like this, you just copy it. We have a Leighton square of order 5. Then go to OpiStat home page, and you will see the Leighton square design at the bottom. Click on it, place the data here, paste it, and here you can mention the character name, say yield, so, and then submit. So total number of variable submitted, for we have submitted only one variable, and number of treatments are 5, and analyze it. So your analysis is present here, in which rows, the sources of variation are rows, column, treatment and error. So as we discussed in our theory part, you can compare various treatment with the help of CD at 5% or CD at 1%. So this is all about this experimental design and how you analyze using this software. There are so many software also available. You can analyze your data with the help of R, with the help of SPSS, or with the help of SAS, or MATLAB, etc., etc. There are many software available, but they are commercial. Except R is a freely available software, but it requires some programming skill. And this is a freely available software, freely available in domain. You can use it, and if any difficulty is there, you always contact me for the solution. Thank you. Thank you very much.